The main challenge we face as cocoa-producing families is to increase our production. On our farms, some trees produce a little while others produce a lot. Some never get sick, and others lose every pod they produce to diseases. Grafts, air layering, and rooted cuttings are ways to reproduce our best cocoa trees and increase the farm's production. In grafting, parts of two plants are joined to produce a new plant. One plant supplies the roots and the other the crown. With air layering, a new cocoa plant is produced by stimulating a branch to form roots while it is still attached to the tree. For rooted cuttings, a new plant is produced by cutting and stimulating a branch, a young scion, to put out both roots and crown. Today, we are going to learn how to do grafts, air layering, and rooted cuttings. Let's look at some of the advantages of using these techniques. We will visit the farms of Katia, Irene, and Marina, who have experience in using grafts, air layering, and rooted cuttings, and are willing to share their experiences with us.
La ventaja es que es un manejo es más fácil, mayor producción y en menor tiempo, que para nosotros los productores es una ayuda porque no tenemos que esperar más años para ver una buena producción. Estas plantas de cacao son tienen, pues, según el estudio, son resistentes a más enfermedades, su producción es más rápida y tiene una ventaja para los productores que es el manejo.
El manejo acá yo veo que es un poco más viable. Digamos, no se llena mucho de enfermedades, que si hay, pues uno puede venir cortarlo con tranquilidad.
Es un cacao bajo, manejable, bastante producción, y menos monilia, cosecha más.
Y eso es algo que también es importante, produce muy temprano.
Claro que sí, se ve el cambio de la finca, en la producción que está produciendo casi todo el año.
Para mí ha sido muy buena porque es la primera experiencia, ha sido muy buena y hemos tenido ya una corta de 40 kilos de cacao. Bueno, al principio, como era algo nuevo para uno como productor, sí fue un poquito más difícil, pero poniéndolo en práctica, llevando el manejo, sí, ya se le vuelve una rutina y es fácil.
Sí, sí le recomiendo a otros productores y productoras.
To learn how to reproduce cocoa through grafts, air layering, or rooted cuttings, we must first study the parts of the cocoa plant. Chupons are shoots that grow upward from the trunk of the tree between the base of the trunk and its main fork, the orquette. Buds are plant growth organs that can develop into branches, leaves, flowers, and new plants. Buds are found at the base of the leaves and the tips of the branches. When the seed germinates, the cotyledons open as leaves and provide the food the small plant needs to survive until it has its own leaves and produces its own food. Cotyledons are the parts of the plant that correspond to the cocoa bean. Scions are pieces of a branch. The scions should have the same thickness and color as the rootstock where we are going to make the graft. Bark is the tough skin covering that protects the branches and trunk. Between the bark and the wood of the branch, there is a moist, sticky layer called cambium. The cambium is responsible for successfully joining the bud to the rootstock. For grafting, we need simple tools that are easy to obtain. We need pruning shears, knife, and sharpening stone. Also, we need transparent plastic strips measuring about 2 centimeters wide and 20 centimeters long, which we can make from thin, cheap plastic bags, moist newsprint paper or banana leaves, color tape labels, and a permanent marker to identify our grafts. Now, let's take a detailed look at how to do grafts, air layering, and rooted cuttings. Bud grafts join a bud, which will provide the crown of the new tree, with the rootstock, which will provide the roots. These grafts can be made on rootstock of any size, but it is necessary that the bud and the rootstock have the same thickness and color of bark. To graft a bud, We first take the rootstock and make 3 cuts just below the scars of the cotyledons, so that when you lift the bark, a tongue is formed. Then, we cut a bud from the scion. The bud we cut should be the same size as the cut we made on the rootstock. We place the bud as if it were a patch on the cut, cover it with the tongue, and secure it with a plastic strip, wrapping it around several times, binding it snugly from above to below so that it is securely attached and so that no water can get in. Finally, we make a knot so the plastic does not come loose. 15 days after making the graft, we remove the plastic to see whether the bud is green and well attached to the rootstock, which indicates that the graft is successful. If we find that the graft has taken hold, then we immediately tip the rootstock, leaving about 4 leaves so that they can continue working to provide food to the rootstock and graft. We eliminate all of the shoots and suckers that grow on the rootstock so that they do not weaken the graft or cause a confusion with the bud graft we made. Once the graft has grown to form a branch with 4 or more leaves, we eliminate the stem from the rootstock, cutting it 10 centimeters above the graft. A scion to be grafted should have the same withe and bark color as the rootstock. There are 2 ways to graft scions: on the side of the rootstocks, known as the side graft, or on top of the rootstock, known as cleft graft or top graft. Scions grafts can be made in the nursery or in chupons in the field. So this way, we can replace unproductive trees using their chupons or suckers as rootstock. To graft a chupon, we first eliminate all of the other chupons and leave only the one closest to the ground. Chupons 1 cm thick are tipped and a 4 cm deep downward cut is made, splitting the stem into 2 halves. We take a scion with the same thickness as the chupon, and on the thicker end, we make 2 slanted cuts 4 centimeters long each, forming a wedge shape. We carefully place the wedge in the cut on the stem and tie it with a plastic strip to keep it in place. Then, we cover it with an elongated plastic bag to protect it from moisture. When the grafted scion has branches and each branch has at least 4 leaves, we gradually eliminate the crown of the old or unproductive tree to give the graft more light and stimulate its growth, that we are replacing to allow the grafts to receive more light, grow well, and form the crown of a new tree. Grafting is easy. Let's ask some experienced grafters.
Al principio fue un poco complicado realizar los injertos porque no se tiene la técnica suficiente y la práctica. Cuando inicié vi que era muy difícil y no me animaba, pero los compañeros me motivaron a hacerlo.
En un mes, los primeros días, lógicamente, la persona por falta de práctica, pues comete errores y inclusive a veces hace malos cortes. Yo la primera vez, pues no tuve una pega muy buena, pero en la segunda ya mejoré bastante.
Al principio práctica, da miedo a veces, pero no es nada imposible, simplemente ponerse la meta de que uno puede lograr las cosas. Yo cuando inicié lo vi muy complicado, pero los compañeros me motivaron y me animé a hacerlo. Con el paso del tiempo y la práctica vas mejorando el pegue. Yo empecé, qué sé yo, hice 50 injertos y de esos me pegaron 15 o 10. Bueno, digo yo, malísimo, porque los compañeros míos pegaban mucho. Y seguí practicando y llegué a pegar, qué sé yo, de 100 injertos, pegaba 70, 80. Entonces ya es algo que usted se siente muy bien porque sabe que su trabajo está realmente funcionando.
Yo siempre, desde que aprendí la injertación, no he dejado de practicarla. Con la práctica se hace el técnico.
Les recomiendo a los productores que lo practiquen, que lo pongan en práctica, ya que reducen el tiempo de producción, mejoran el volumen de producción en sus cultivos, aparte de que reducen muchos costos en la mano de obra, ya que no van a utilizar escaleras para cosechar, qué sé yo, canastas, andar arriba de los árboles, que es muy peligroso.
As the experts say, practice and practice are the keys to successful grafting. Now, let's see how to do grafts on unproductive adult trees. Unproductive cocoa trees can be side grafted, a technique known as malayo grafts. In this case, the rootstock is the trunk of the tree we want to replace. To make cuts in the bark of an adult tree, we need a knife or a short, very sharp machete. The malayo graft should be made on a clean, healthy trunk, free of knots, up to 80 centimeters above ground level. To do a malayo graft, first we must choose a scion 1 centimeter thick and 7 centimeters long, mature, brown in color, with 2 or 3 buds. We cut the leaves off the scion and make slanted cuts on its thickest end. One cut 3 centimeters long and the other 5 centimeters. We make a horizontal cut in the bark of the trunk, down to the wood. Then, about 10 centimeters above, we make another cut in the bark slanted inward and downward until we reach the horizontal cut forming a window. Then, we make a third vertical cut about 6 centimeters long, downward toward the center of the horizontal cut. We pull the bark out, insert the scion, and tie it with a cord or wrapping it around the trunk as tightly as possible. We cover the graft with a large plastic bag and tie it above and below the graft. We fold the upper end of the bag over so that the water cannot enter. After a month, we check to see whether the buds of the scion have begun to sprout. Then we take off the plastic bag, leaving the scion tied to the rootstock for 60 more days, or until the graft has branches and leaves and is well attached to the trunk. When about 8 months have passed, or when the graft begins to produce fruits, we gradually cut the crown of the tree to stimulate the development and production of the graft. Let's look now at how to do rooted cuttings and air layering of cocoa. To root cocoa cuttings, we do half of the work in the field and half in the nursery. In the field, we select and cut the cuttings, thin scions, and root them in the nursery. Then, we care for them and help them grow until they are ready to be transplanted to the field. It is very important to choose young cuttings, half a centimeter thick and 20 centimeters long, that are near the end of the branch and are mixed brown and green in color. We cut the cuttings half a centimeter above their base. Early in the morning, to avoid heat and desiccation, the scions are wrapped in moist newspaper or banana leaves and taken to the nursery. In the nursery, we cut off 2/3 of each leaf and make a slanted cut in the thickest end of the cutting. We apply a hormone, a root stimulant, and put them in a nursery bag. Then, we put the bags in a row and cover them with yellow, blue, or transparent plastic, forming an airtight chamber. The rooting chamber should remain sealed for about 45 to 60 days, without watering it or uncovering it. Since the cuttings must be kept humid, we must wet well the substrate in the plastic bags before putting the cuttings into root. Once 45 to 60 days have passed, we gradually remove the plastic. The first day, we uncover it for 1 hour and increase the time exposed by 1 hour each day until it is uncovered for 8 hours. From then on, the cuttings are left exposed all the time until they are ready to be transplanted in the field. The last technique that we will look at today is air layering. In air layering, we stimulate a branch to root while still attached to the tree. First, we choose a healthy branch, 1 centimeter thick, with all its leaves. We make 2 circular cuts on the branch, forming a ring within which we eliminate the bark, leaving the wood exposed. We apply rooting hormone to the ring of the branch, cover it with moist substrate or moss, and cover it with black plastic tie to the branch on either end. Adjust the plastic well so there is contact between the ringed area and the substrate. The air layers should remain covered about 30 to 40 days until they put out roots. Once they have roots, cut the branch 15 centimeters below the roots and plant them in the nursery bags filled with substrate. We take care of them until they put out leaves and the leaves mature. Then the plant is ready to be transplanted in the field. Grafting, air layering, and rooted cuttings are very useful techniques to reproduce our best cocoa trees. All you have to do is practice, practice, and more practice. you will clearly see your coco production go up to. Try and see. See you soon.